In America, way of doing business in Japan, the way of doing business is a huge. I just feel like I came to Mars, you know, when I came to UFC.
Do you think part of that is because you were best fighter in Japan at one point, and here you're working your way up?
No, it has nothing to do. It has every fighter in the UFC is going to the same dream. You know, in Japan, it just wasn't like that. You know, just came, driver picked me up at the airport. I came in. I always stayed in the same hotel. You know, and I was the only fighter there. You know, and here we are meeting your opponent, fighters. Some people doesn't know the level where they can go to. So there are parties during the night that wakes you up in the same floor. There are maybe 3-4 fighters and plus cornermans, and they are doing madness, you know, during the night, make you nervous, you know. I just didn't meet that before in Japan. I just had my peace, you know, and I just didn't like it. You know.
Did you express that to Dana, and what was his response if you did?
No, I didn't. I didn't talk to them. I don't think Dana would understand it. You know? I understand this is the way UFC works, and I have to respect that. If I want to participate, I have to respect. I'm professional, and I will swallow anything.
Will that be part of your negotiations for the next go?
No. I know that people expect me to see, and I just don't want to be a black sheep between all the fighters.
You gonna hang around? You gonna do any fishing while you're here?
Fishing?
You know, there's great fishing spots here.
Maybe only fishes with two legs.
Earlier, Pat said that he considered you at one time the best fighter on the planet.
Who?
Pat Barry said that you were the best fighter on the planet, and that you kind of reset the bar for striking in MMA. But you set the bar really high, and everybody's had to play catch up. Do you feel like that the other fighters are now catching up to where you're at as far as their striking level and overall game?
I don't know, but game is developing. You cannot stop. Fighters in the future, maybe not now, but in 5, 10, 15, 20 years, you know, we'll have more and more complete fighters. Before, you remember when UFC starts, there was, you know, on the card when they present the fighters, they said jiu-jitsu versus wrestling, and then the boxing versus, I don't know, taekwondo. Right. Today, you need to know everything, you know.
Exactly.
I start, it was very hard for me because I start from kickboxing. It is much easier to start as a first class grappler or jiu-jitsu fighter, how to adapt for striking. It's much easier, you know. You don't have much. Jab, left, right, jab, maybe knee, and that's it enough. If you are solid, but to learn how to fight on the ground, it takes 10 years, you know. But to learn how to throw a jab or two, or maybe some uppercut, doesn't matter how technically, but uppercut, if you are catched with the MMA glove, doesn't have to be technically perfect, you know. So it was much easier to adapt for the. But today fighters, the new generation of fighter who will come definitely. They will train just like I'm training now. But I'm 35 now. If I'm 20 years old now, I don't know where will be my edge, you know. Because now I train one day grappling and jiu-jitsu, another training Muay Thai. So it is perfect combination. You know? But before, everybody was or Thai boxer or jiu-jitsu or judo fighter. You know, they knew, for example, in Japan, and there was excellent Olympic winners in judo, but they were expert in judo, you know. It was not judo competition, you know? So when they get punched or kicked or low kicked, they didn't know what's going on. But with the time, sport will definitely is going to be developed, definitely.
When you first came into the UFC, I think everybody kind of expected you to come in and just start knocking guys out left and right. Yeah. And, you know, you struggled in a couple of fights, but do you think that's part of it, is just that guys were catching on and maybe some of the fights you had in Japan, you know, you were still fighting that style versus style competition, and then you came here and they matched you up with guys that were a little more well-rounded, and so maybe that...
I don't think so. Maybe it was a bad time for me, you know. I was sick of everything, of training, you know. I just won the Grand Prix in the Pride and... tell the truth, money attracts me, you know, here. Money attracts me because I knew that Pride is going to be finished, and it is the worst motivation that fighter can have, money, you know. And then I trained, you know, I trained solid, but not the way I should. And then I underestimate the phenomenon called cage. It's a huge difference is to fight whole your career in the ring and then you just enter the cage. The cage is at least twice bigger than the ring, and there is no ropes, you know, different rules worth in the cage, you know. And, it was a shock for me, and different kind of public in Japan, you know. It was a shock for me, you know. In Japan, when you are fighting, you feel like that you are in Vienna in concert, listening some opera. Everybody is quiet, keep quiet. Only when you do some move, the whoo, and but here, you know, people are screaming and this and that, you know, different mentality. It was all those things small, but when you put 10 things, you know, it's a big thing, you know, for me.
It sounds like you prefer your time in Pride, and you prefer the people in Pride, the fans.
No, it's not true. I'm fighting UFC, and of course I prefer UFC. Pride is dead. Pride doesn't exist, and I need to adapt on a new situation. There is no ring in MMA world today. There is strike force. There is people are fighting only in the cage, and you have to accept it. At the end of the day, I have a cage in my gym too, so we are training only in the cage.